Welcome back. The media is at it again to protect their Manchurian candidate. No surprise. The level of coordination between the Democratic Party and the mainstream is astounding. But because their candidate, Kamala Harris, is so incompetent, their defense and protection of her has hit a fever pitch. First, if you'll remember, Donna Brazile at CNN provided Hillary Clinton the questions ahead of time back in 2016, and now this from CBS. Kamala Harris sat down with Bill Whitaker of CBS's 60 Minutes on her media blitz Sunday. It was supposed to showcase her command of the issues and her ability to look presidential. It appears CBS went to great lengths, though, to make sure that this was the case, so they had to edit it. Watch this breakdown of Kamala's unedited response versus what actually aired.
But it seems that Prime Minister Netanyahu is not listening.
Well, Bill, the work that we have done has resulted in a number of movements in that region by Israel that were very much prompted by or a result of many things, including our advocacy for what needs to happen in the region.
But it seems that Prime Minister Netanyahu is not listening.
We are not going to stop pursuing what is necessary for the United States to be clear about where we stand on the need for this war to end.
Unbelievable. She's really, really bad at this. She's caught looking like a kid who did not read the book for the book report. This is not surprising that she could not answer questions or present an argument. It's hard to do when you've been propped up as this prosecutor, but in reality, you barely showed up for court. But after blowback on social media, the Harris campaign stated it did not have anything to do with the editing and that that was entirely CBS's purview. But if the media is blatantly running this type of cover, how is this not election interference? Joining us now is Dr. Carol Swain. She's a former professor at law at Vanderbilt University and served as an advisor of President Trump's 1776 commission. She also has a new book out, The Adversity of Diversity, How the Supreme Court's Decision to Remove Race from College Admissions Criteria Will Doom Diversity Programs. Great read. So great, in fact, Dr. Swain. You've had some rather famous people plagiarize from you, but that's a different topic. Welcome to the program.
I can tell you that I thought Claudine Gay was the poster child for the adversity of diversity until Kamala Harris was nominated as the Democrat presidential candidate. And you cannot get more DEI than Kamala Harris, because if you will recall, Joe Biden told the world that he was going to select a woman as a running mate. And then about maybe it was 100 black women signed a letter insisting that it be a black woman. So he had already curtailed the choices when he said it had to be a woman. And then the under pressure, it had to be a black woman. And then it narrowed down to Stacey Abrams and Kamala Harris. And we're stuck with Kamala Harris. And when you talk about DEI and Kamala Harris in the same breath, people will say, oh, it's white racist Republican speaking. I'm not a white racist Republican. I am someone that has talked about the dangers of DEI. You don't want it running the country. You don't want it in the military. You don't want it in our public schools. And we see it with Kamala Harris. That's why they have to edit everything. That's why she's afraid. And she's not a woman that worked hard the way we did to reach our positions. She's someone that has used her sexual appeal to elevate herself, and she's not qualified for the position of nominee.
Dr. Swain, you'd think that someone at this level now, with as much scrutiny as she has, would at least start working now. But even now, it seems like she's not kicking in that work gear. Or she's just incapable of it, because look at how unprepared she is for a basic question. This is not an unpredictable topic. You're going to talk about Israel when you sit down with CBS. So there's no preparation for this question at all. And it makes you wonder what the Democrats must be thinking at this point with her taking the lead for their entire party and making this pitch to the American people, but falling on her face in front of the world.
To her credit, she did not start the answer with, I was raised as a middle-class child or middle-class kid. And so she struggled with her answers. And I think it is her her inability that she is not up to the job. And even if she does prepare the way she did for the debate with Donald Trump, where she memorized copious amounts of data so that she could give a speech behind questions that she obviously had in advance. And so Democrats, they cheat, they justify plagiarism. And with Kamala Harris, I don't know why I want to call her Kamala Hall, but Kamala Harris, she's not qualified for the position, and they have propped her up. And I don't believe if she's elected that she'd actually be running the country. I think whoever is running the country now, whichever group of people that are in charge of Joe Biden and in charge of America, they would be still in charge with the Kamala Harris presidency. That's my position, but I was recently discussing this with someone who said the nightmare would be if after elected, Kamala Harris decided that she had her own ideas and her own agenda. We know that she's incompetent and that we should fear what would happen if she had the power of the presidency. Maybe the people who are controlling things now would not be able to control her. And so we don't know what she would do because she's certainly not qualified for the job.
That is a great point. I mean, when dumb people attain power, they become very dangerous. And in this case, that looks like the path we're on if she is someone who gains that White House. But as someone who ostensibly comes from the law, she says she's this hard-nosed prosecutor. We don't have a lot of records of her actually being in court or actually trying or appealing cases in her legal career. When she is this fumbling on some pretty important topics, you only shudder to think what her understanding and grasp of the U.S. Constitution must be, because the seat that she is selling herself for, that she is calling all Americans to vote for her into, requires a president who is going to uphold the Constitution and protect it. I shudder to think what her understanding of the Constitution is.
We've not had people who seem to understand the Constitution and are willing to uphold it in a long time. And so you can go back to the Supreme Court Justice from Harvard. There was no clear evidence that she fully understood the Constitution. And I think that the Democratic Party has made a decision. They've made a decision that the Constitution doesn't matter. Things like free speech, the rule of law, the right to assemble, just various things, the due process that we have taken for granted, equal protection of the laws, they have pretty much thrown that out of the window. And so, if she's elected as president, I think that for Americans who have been accustomed to freedoms, we will lose more freedoms under her than we've lost already during the Obama and Biden administrations, when we saw our government go after its citizens. And for the first time in my awareness, we have political prisoners. We have people who are serving time in jail, first-time offenders for things that no one, if they were a Democrat, had a D beside their name, would go to jail for, or would even be prosecuted. And so I think there would be more of that with a Harris presidency.
It's hard to imagine that we'd have more of that double standard, but there's certainly room for it, especially under Kamala Harris. Dr. Carol Swain, always a pleasure. Thank you so much for the time. Don't go anywhere. Our next conversation has to do with cults and climate change. Fascinating discussion. Stay right here. We'll be right back.